with the last video where I sounded so dominative. I actually have to clarify. Okay, so France is the builder, manufacturer, supplier of the parts and the weapons and the airplanes that are handled by EU coalition forces in each country. Okay, so there's Spain. Spain does not have just its Spanish force any longer. It's an EU coalition force. So we're not having wild Spain. Okay. Same goes for France. Same goes for Italy. So we have the EU coalition forces. It's no longer the Hungarians dancing their Hungarian rebel whatever. They can't do that. No. It's we have to quell everything and stop it. Stop acting so Maharaji that you're gonna just go and get. Okay. And so then it goes back to the votes. You know, let's say, okay, you want to raise your hand. Let's say you're Germany and you've decided, that's it, I'm going to war with Poland. Well, and for you to go to war with Poland, remember, you are EU coalition forces now. All right, so they only are run by a vote by the EU group itself. Now, the EU group itself is a vote by, let's say we have Queen of Spain, let's say we have Queen of France, let's say we have King of England. Okay, so we take votes from these sources. And then secondly, we take votes from the socialists, let's say Germany has its socialist government still and decided not to. No sovereignty, so they're just a socialist rule. So yeah, their group, yay or nay. So each one, they've already decided, you know, they had decided to go to war with Poland, but I know the chances are pretty slim for it to happen, but we'll never say never. Okay, I didn't mean to make Germany as the big bully there, but it is possible. Okay. And so there we have like Greece. Oh my gosh, you know, Greece and Turkey, you know, they can easily get a little at each other. So yeah, those types of things, you know. So that we have the whole EU, you know, we have the Queen of Spain, we have the Queen of France, we have the King of England making that decision, going, no, you're not gonna fight. There's not gonna be a war between Turkey and Greece this year. You know, because what you do when you have a war, if it's internal or it's external, well, I'm not talking external right now, but if it's internal, that just stops our trade, it stops all kinds of things, stops our tourism, we are all affected. It affects the flights, nothing is smooth any longer, nothing. We don't have smooth travel, we don't have, our regular life is disrupted. In a way, how dare you? No, we won't have wars between Turkey and Greece. All right? So, and whoever's got their fingers on the weapons now is just the EU coalition. So it's no longer going to be Turkey. It's no longer going to be Greece. It's going to be the EU coalition waiting for the orders. Okay? So. Now, on an external, like we had with France went off to the Middle East, you know, to play like, well, we'll just be like helpers. That was what they tried to sell, that they were only going to be helpers. But they weren't helpers. They ended up being bombers and attackers, and they entered into a combat. So they were not just helpers. And that was very, very unpopular to the French people. It was very unpopular to all of Europe. Nobody really liked France hoofy-footing it over there. It looked like some kind of placency with the United States, like they were involved in some kind of extraordinary buddy system. You know, snob-nobbing it with somebody from the U.S. So, yeah. And, you know, when all of this happens, it's dissent in your land. It's dissent amongst your people. You know. So we're trying to avoid dissent amongst the people. That's always key. All right, so, yeah. So any time, let's say, you know, France gets its little sniffly nose up again, you know, the little socialist parliamentary there gets like, well, wait. Can't we go over there? Can't we go over there? No, this is going to be a decision now by all of us. It's going to be a decision made by all of us. It's going to be a decision made even by Denmark. Denmark is going to be invited to that table. Can France go over and actually fight in combat if it wants to? No. Denmark says no. You understand? That's only Denmark's vote, though. So it's going to be a majority rule. If we want the French, we could say the French group, but it's still going to be the EU coalition of soldiers there in France. Sent from France. So that's the way it goes. It's going to be an EU coalition group sent. So if Denmark says no, if Sweden says yes, if the UK says yes, you know, if we have a majority starting to say yes, well then that French EU coalition group of soldiers and equipment goes. But only because of that majority group vote. The little Queen of Spain said no. She didn't want it. And it doesn't matter. She lost out. She lost out on that particular, you know. And even if I, you know, dissent, I say no. Doesn't matter. If the majority is out there saying yes, if Italy is saying yes, if I have a Switzerland in agreement, you know, it just starts racking up that we have to go where? I don't know, Egypt? Apparently we have to go to Egypt. Well, I'm not going to say no. It's still the EU group vote majority decision. Okay? So this is about the manufacturing supplier being based out of France. So yeah, oh my gosh, how easy, you know, the equipment only is from one place, you know, instead of 50. All right, how easy, it's much better. All right, so I think I made it clear now. I know, it's kind of upsetting to the old Swiss way, you know, when you're 19, you go out and you shoot a gun or whatever. I know that's upsetting because you'll be next to an EU coalition member at the same time. But that's just the way it has to be done. You know, because then the EU itself is massified. Do you understand? We are megafied and massified in the eyes of others. Just that quickly. Whoa. You're all together? Do you see the power now? All together. Whoa, it's a lot, you know, and then you're like, well, I guess you're not going to get a tax from, you know, you're not going to get a tax from Polynesia anytime soon. Yeah, I know.